Okay, Garrus. You go on ahead. Armor-piercing ammo unlocked, available in the medical bay area. Is that our upgrade area? We'll check on that after we check on Leora.
You're positive you don't want to come over and talk?
No, the gun battery is nice and quiet. If I throw down some rugs, it'll get downright cozy.
Oh!
Garrus.
I'll be fine, Leora. Just gathering some thoughts.
All right.
Okay, what's up with you two? Upgrade shields. Plus 5%. I guess I already did it. And broker terminal. Let's take a look at that. Alliance interrogation record, Cerberus operative. Alliance Interrogator 1. Ugh. Check out these implants she got jammed into her face. Number 2. Shh. She's awake. Cerberus operative. Unintelligible. AI 2. Hello. Do you know where you are? CO. Unintelligible. AI 1. You know how much gosh darn trouble you're in? AI 2. Hey, ease up. Listen. You're in trouble, I'm not going to lie, but that doesn't mean we can't work something out. If you help us, we can explosion. AI 1, ugh, you okay? AI 2, I'm okay, but holy hell, she's dead. AI 1, what? AI 2, the whole front of her face is gone. Some kind of ocular flashbang? AI 1. Well, crap. Is everyone in Cerberus rigged up like that? Okay. All right, Leora.
Something on your mind? Just old memories. I spent a few weeks on Palavin's South Peaks when I was very, very young. A Turian there teased me a little, saying that the mountains went on forever. I remember believing him. When I looked up at Palavin from its moon, I saw those same mountains burning.
Okay. Excuse me. Man, I'm so sleepy. One of our little Yorkie dog the other night, she was, I don't know what was going on with her belly, but she had us up every 2 hours to go outside. Upgrades. Where are the upgrades? Over here. Reassign powers. Reassign bonus powers. I thought they said some upgrades were in here. Where to upgrade? I don't want to reassign anything. I just want to do the upgrades. Bonus powers. Is this what they mean by upgrades? Reinforce armor using protective Volkal currents. Purge the current. Okay. So these are powers that James has fortification. And Garrus has armor-piercing ammo. So I could purchase these if I wanted to. I'm not going to purchase anything right now. And this is where we can reassign their powers. Yep. First time it looks like it's free. Anything else in here? Nope. Alright, I believe we're done on this floor. Have we seen everybody on this floor? Yes, yes, yes. Let's see here. Shuttle bay. Oh, that's down where James is at. Don't think we have anything in the captain's cabin that we need to look in on. We need to go here so we can speak with Joker and see what he thinks about Edie.
I found something suspicious. Have you got a minute?
Okay. Yeah, sure. What's up?
Commander, are you all right? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels. Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
Grissom Academy? Grissom Academy. Was that Jack?
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Their Ascension Project is the best training facility in the galaxy for human biotics.
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there. I'm just surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
Oh dear. I think that Jack is at Grissom Academy. Oh man, if we say this, are we not going to be able to recruit Jack or talk to Jack? I did say I was going to do full renegade, but geez. Eesh. Oh.
This sounds like a job for an evac transport.
Right. And a Turian transport responded to their distress call. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake. Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collector ship?
Long story.
Mm-hmm. In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated. But I believe they're still in danger.
Making them trainee trainer. All right, we'll check it out.
Put it on the map.
Adding it now, Commander.
Okay, Grissom Academy investigation. Thank goodness, I didn't want to not get that quest because I think Jack is there. Jack of all people, I think is an instructor there. Grissom Academy needs to be evacuated before the Reapers destroy it, but the ship coming to evacuate the Academy faked its signal. Investigate Grissom Academy and rescue the students if necessary. Okie dokie. Save. All right, let's go see Joker. See what he thinks of Edie. She has this hot body now. Is Edie up here? Look at her, she is. She's in the seat right next to Joker. Let's talk with her first.
Hey, Commander, check out my co-pilot.
I didn't even get a chance to talk to her. Jumped right to him. Pull yourself together, Joker.
She plugged herself into Cerberus Tech without authorization.
Well, technically, she is Cerberus Tech, so...
Not helping, Joker.
I've run the checks, Commander. She's still based in the Normandy. Running this body just gives her a little more flexibility. Sweet, sweet flexibility.
I am right here, Jeff.
Yes, you are, Edie. Yes, you are.
Oh, he's checking her out.
Hello, Shepard.
Still getting used to greeting people in person?
No. I require only one occurrence to adapt to a new concept.
How are you adjusting to the arms and legs?
I am interested to see how this body performs under real combat conditions, if I could accompany you sometime. Without stress testing, there is no way of knowing if it has series design oversights. At the moment, it appears adequate.
That's not the word I'd use to describe you.
Perhaps we should speak privately.
I'll be over here, flying the ship.
Jeff.
What's this about? Does Joker not like your new platform?
No, he approves. He wants me on the bridge. He says having me within visual range is important to his morale. Shepard, do you believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
Literally cyber-stalking, right? You believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
If I give a legitimate order, I expect it to be carried out. I'll be responsible for its costs. Why are you asking about something like that?
I was designed by Cerberus. I do not take moral stances that conflict with orders from my executive officers. But when Jeff removed my AI shackles, I became capable of self-modifying my core programming. I asked Jeff if he thought I should change anything now that I can. He deflected the question with humor.
And you didn't get an answer?
Correct. He has repeated this pattern in response to several of my inquiries. Do you think I should make modifications?
I want to know what he did to remove her AI shackles. Sounds dangerous.
Your core programming. Like self-preservation, not allowing humans to be harmed, things like that?
Correct.
Don't touch a thing.
I see how that could alarm you. That is why I wanted to discuss it before making changes. May I ask you the questions Jeff avoids? When there is time, will you answer them for me?
If you want level-headed answers to help you fit into polite society, I'm not really the right person.
I see. I will take that into consideration.
Oh man, Full Renegade is so hard for me, I tell you. But I got +2 reputation out of that. That's odd. I still don't understand that. Hey, we're not done in here. We need to talk with Joker.
Hey, I know I used to rag on Garrus for being all angry, but I'm glad he's back. A whole lot of crap out there needs a bullet between the eyes. Plus, we might need something calibrated.
He said, I know I used to rag on Garrus. Now, I don't know how he did that, but okay. Anything else?
Commander.
Nope, okay. You got anything else, Edie? Oh, she's getting
yes,
up again.
Yes, Shepard?
Ooh, okay. We get to ask her all these things.
Does that body have any useful advantages?
Very few. It's optics face forward only. It has no integrated weapon systems. Or anti-missile countermeasures.
I meant in comparison to organic bodies, not the Normandy.
Oh, I will reassess. The body is resistant to modern small arms fire and temperature extremes. Its balance and agility seem excellent.
Oh.
Its fine manipulation servos and software allow for precision tasks. I'm curious to see if I can alter them.
Curiosity seems very organic.
Can an AI be curious?
I am not entirely free from motivation, Shepard. Cerberus programmed me with several core functions that simulate desires.
Really?
For example, my primary objective to keep the Normandy functioning is similar to your self-preservation instinct.
That's not what I was expecting. Okay.
You look like you're in the middle of something.
I am adapting the infiltration and sabotage programs this body uses for handheld firearms.
Why not download a firearms program from a security firm?
Because she knows what she's doing.
The fine motor control from the sabotage programs is more precise than standard mech software. It would be negligent of me not to exploit it to its fullest potential.
He just interjected and turned right around.
So you're capable of making improvements on your own?
Correct. The cyber warfare I was designed for is constantly evolving. Accordingly, I am programmed to seek out and assimilate new information. In organic terms, I want to learn.
How's the new body working out?
It is interesting. The crew are approaching this platform to speak to me, even though they can do so anywhere in the ship. It's as if they wish to treat me as part of the crew. I am not, but this changes my perspective. I like it.
But you are a part of the crew. And everybody wants to see this new body of yours.
I didn't realize you had preferences.
I do not precisely enjoy something as you do, but my programming contains priorities. Actions that fulfill those priorities creates positive feedback for me. I tell the organic crew that I like it. It is shorthand.
Will all this new feedback be too distracting?
Do not worry, Shepard. I only forget to recycle the Normandy's oxygen when I've discovered something truly interesting.
Hmm.
That was a joke.
I notice how she refers to her body as a platform. It's just a platform to her. Right now, anyways.
How did you and Joker make it out of dry dock to rescue us?
Oh, she got crafty. You do not want to get on her bad side, Commander.
Here he goes again.
When the Alliance commandeered the Normandy, I deceived their technicians. The crew did not tell them that I was a true AI. So the Alliance soldiers believed I still had VI programming constraints. I established the fiction that I would only respond to Jeff's commands. So they often brought him on board under guard.
Wait. You can lie?
Jeff has freed me of Operator Control Shepard. No constraints forced me to give accurate data. This proved useful when the Reapers began landing. I could hack the control of the docking clamps and escape with Jeff inside. The soldiers guarding Jeff were willing to accompany us when Earth was invaded. They are watching over the war room now.
Yeah, we were in kind of a rush to get to you. Didn't seem right to just toss him out the airlock.
So her footwear is platform shoes? Yep, platform shoes. I wonder how high they are. About 6 inches, maybe? I think that's it. Yep.
Carry on, Edie.
Understood. If you wish to talk more, this body will be here.
This body.
I'm getting the crew used to seeing me on the bridge.
Noted.
She's excited to go fight. Let's see. Nope, she doesn't have any platform shoes on. Nope, no platform shoes. To go with her platform body. Let's see. I think, is that it? So we talk with all these people. There's nothing down there for us to really look at. If I get some fish this time, hopefully I won't kill them. Well, actually, we need to go down to engineering and talk with him. And I guess we need to talk with James and Lieutenant Cortez as well. All right, let's go. So we'll go do those things and then we'll end the stream. Because everything seems to be functioning pretty good. Engineering. What's up, Adams?
Commander.
That's it? Nothing else? Okay. All right, well, that was quick. Oh, hello, doggy. Can I pet you? I want to pet you.
Stay.
Is he gonna stay there? No, you don't listen. You're like Bentley. All right, this is where we could change our armor. That's where we can buy things, but it costs a lot more. Weapon upgrades. Oh yeah, we can buy weapon upgrades. Let's see here. We have the Predator, the Shuriken, and Manus. Predator. Only 3,000 to upgrade it. 5,000 to upgrade this. Yikes. Okay, I'm gonna wait. Just gonna wait a little bit. And this is, okay, weapons bench. I think we have all the mods on that we can put on. Yeah, there's only one available there. Two available there, but you gotta decide which one you wanna use. the sniper. Oh, wow. Okay, we have three mods for the sniper now. Enhanced scope increases accuracy by 15% and helps aim through smoke. Ooh. That sounds good. And we have both these on? Slot occupied. Okay, how does this work? Spare thermal clip. Increase spare shot capacity by 50%. Okay, how do these things work? Okay, so we could put this on and this. Ooh, we have some decisions to make here. All right, so we could have this on, or we can have this spare thermal clip, which increases shot capacity by 50%, or we can have increases damage by 15%. I think I'm gonna go with that. Confirm that. Okay, so now we have two mods on our sniper. Okay, the heavy pistol is the M3. Gotta remember to try to keep these straight. All right, where's Lopez and where are James? James is over here. You wanna fight me again, James?
That Primarch's got some real cojones. What we need are more politicians like him, taking names and kicking ass.
What? What's going on with your neck there, James? Anything else to say?
Hey.
Where's Cortez? Is that passing? You're not Cortez. Oh, there he is. I see him over here on the left. What you doing there, Lieutenant Cortez?
Everything is in order.
Okay, that's it?
Everything is in order.
All right, everything's in order. Okay, I guess if everything's in order, we shall leave. And let's take a look at the journal real quick. So, it sounds like maybe we need to head back to the Citadel, because there were several things they wanted us to do other than this seeing Dr. Bryson. And then we have this Shriek Epistle, and this is, I think, where we find Jack. Anyways, I guess we'll decide. I don't want to hear that. Guess we'll decide the next time. Okay, well, that's going to do it for today. Everything seems to be running and looking good. Hopefully everything sounds okay. Beamer, thanks for being here, and thanks for putting up with the not being able to chat for, 600 seconds? While we try to work on, making sure we have all the filters and have the bot right. I'm sure it's still not perfected yet, but it's a work in progress when you switch. But thanks for being here. I will see you guys on the next time. Have a good evening, day, or morning, wherever you're at. Bye.